Hi, and welcome to Retro Eric. Today we are going to talk about this adapter. We are calling it the ISB-BUS Extender adapter. And I've created this together with my friend Kjell Sundby, who is a fellow retro enthusiast here from Norway. So, what is the ISB-BUS Extender adapter? Well, with this adapter, you can extend your ISB-BUS, your 8-bit ISB-BUS, to an external ISB-BUS card. Like the one we have here, the one we are testing with today is the one you can buy on Aliexpress, called ISB-BUS Extender for the 8088 book. You've probably seen videos about that. But you can basically use any external ISB-BUS cards for this. And Aliexpress sells a bunch of them. But we've only tested this so far on this one. So what I've done here, I have connected the ISB-BUS adapter to the ISB-BUS, to the one and only ISB-BUS on this Euro PC. And then with this 64-pin cable, we have another adapter, just the same, going into the ISB-BUS card. As said, you can use any ISB-BUS card, but we are using this one that is sold by the 8088 book guy on AliExpress. So what you can see here is that I have inserted an XTID card and the Resound OPL3 card from Texelec. And if I turn on speakers, we can hear that also works. The setup I'm testing now, as I mentioned, it uses a 64-pin cable. You can also use a 60-pin cable, a thinner one, and connect that directly to the ISB-BUS card. More on that later. Anyway, this setup works okay. Well, perfect. There's nothing wrong with it. I have not even connected. Where's the wire? There is the wire. This is 5V plus. I can connect 5V plus to the ISB-BUS card if I need, but with the 64-pin cable, power is drawn from the computer itself. And in this instance, it's not a problem for the computer to deliver power to these two cards. Let me turn off the sound. Okay. Sorry for my bad voice. I've had a cold now for like 2 or 3 weeks, but I'm getting better. I've also tested this setup with several other cards. These are basically Sound Blaster card, it's an ESS card, and even this brand new MK8330 card. And they all work fine with this setup. Even though those cards are 16-bit, they are still working with only a 8-bit ISB-BUS. Yeah, let me turn off the machine and show you how this is configured. So just let me remove these cards. And here we can see the ISB-BUS that I ordered from AliExpress. It has input for 5V. It has 3 slots. And it has an extra 60-pin connector where you can connect this cable that also comes with the ISB-BUS card. And that is why we have also on our adapter made not only a 64-pin cable, but a 60-pin cable for use especially and only with this ISB-BUS card from AliExpress. So with this setup, it's a bit cleaner, but it has a few drawbacks that we have not solved yet. So let's talk about the problems we have so far. I tested this setup on this Euro PC and it did not work. Well, at least not stable. I was able to use the Adlib card or the ReSound card, but I was not able to use the XT-ID card to boot, not even when I inserted external 5 volt on this. But when I tried the same with this machine, it worked fine. I don't know why it worked on this 386, but did not work on this Euro PC. But I think it has to do with the signal quality. I also tried this 60-pin cable, also same size as the 8088 book ISB-BUS Extender cable. It's twice as long, and with this cable, it did not work stable on the 386 either. So I think that the problem is the 60-pin cable. As we can see, the 60-pin cable has a higher density and the thickness of each cable is less. This is called a 2mm pitch cable and this is 2.55mm pitch cable. And I think that is the problem. And that is why I cannot use a longer cable than this in this machine. And it's probably also why it does not work at all when I'm using this cable. But to the good thing, when using the 64-pin cable, that is 2.55mm pitch, it works perfectly in both machines. Only drawback is that you need to use one of the ISB-BUS connectors for the adapter, and therefore you lose one. Sometimes it's okay. If you use a larger ISB-BUS card, it's probably not a problem. You can buy cards with, well, as many connectors as you want on Aliexpress, so it should not be a problem. One more thing I should mention about this project so far. When using the 60-pin cable, the power is not drawn from the PC, but you have to use external power. Well, that's actually not correct. Let me revise that. You can draw power from the PC, but if you connect external power, the power will not go back into the system. We have one more thing we need to figure out before we start selling this. It will be sold on a web page here in Norway, but with the international, you can order from any country, no problem. We have one thing we need to figure out, and that is if we are using the 64-pin cable and external power on the ISA card, that power will go back into the system. I tried that. It doesn't create a problem. It works totally fine, but it doesn't feel right. So we'll probably figure out some dip switches or jumpers or something you can set here so you can turn off the return of external power back into the system. You probably agree with me that feels like the right thing to do. So let's summarize. With the 64-pin cable, it works very good. It works at least in both those systems we've tested it on. It has a problem when using the smaller 60-pin 2mm pitch cable, and I think that is basically signal degradation because of bad quality cable or, well, not the quality itself maybe, but the thickness of each cable and the distance between them is probably the problem. One more thing before I forget. As you can see here, the cable is, if I'm using this, let me insert this cable here. As you can see, we have a bit of a problem here with the way the cable is connected. Of course, if I put this here inside the machine, you would probably never do that. If you want to probably have a 90 degree angle or something, you will put it here on the outside of the machine, but then again, it's upside down. So we are researching, maybe, I don't know, maybe we'll switch the cable 180 degrees, maybe not, we'll see. This is actually not too bad. Okay, that was just summarizing what has happened the last few weeks since the last video I did on this project. We are a big step closer. We know that it will work, at least with a 64-pin cable. And we'll just iron out a couple of few things before we will start selling this. That's it. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please subscribe to my channel.